Hey, I'm Istana. I'm a risk manager at NordVPN. Today, I'll be looking at some of the most common cybersecurity questions that have appeared on Twitter. So let's get started and jump straight in with number one. First question, how do I know if my social media account has been hacked? Most of us have some form of social media, so it's not surprising that this is one of the most frequent questions. Luckily, a lot of social media apps already have a super useful feature to figure this out. Check your social media app settings for anything that sounds like login activity or login history. If you're suspicious that someone else has access to your account, this setting will show you exactly when and where you last logged in, and also what devices are currently logged in. Don't recognize some of these places or devices? Looks like someone has hacked into your account. Keep an eye on your emails too. The hacker might be trying to change your login details. If you just received a notification email regarding those details, it's time to act fast. Question number two, what should I do if I've been hacked? Okay, so you're definitely certain you've been hacked. The next steps need to be taken as soon as possible. Time is of the essence, and if you can get ahead of the game, then you will have a massive advantage over any cyber criminal. First and foremost, run your antivirus and clear your device of threats. This is so when you essentially come to change your passwords, you won't have any digital threats still lurking around, ready to steal your details again. Speaking of changing passwords, this is your next step. Every account that was on the infected device needs new passwords. Make a list and cross them off once they're done. This might seem a bit much, but you need to be thorough. Question number three, there are so many VPNs to choose from, which one should I go for? Come on. Question number four, what is cyber hygiene and why do I keep seeing the term everywhere? You keep seeing the term everywhere because people are becoming more aware of how important their cybersecurity is. Don't worry, cyber hygiene luckily doesn't involve any soapy water. Cyber hygiene is basically just maintenance of your computer and device's security. It sounds a lot more complex than it actually is. Keeping all your apps up to date with the latest software patches is an example of good cyber hygiene. Other ways to keep cyber hygiene at safe levels would be employing antivirus and privacy protection services, enabling two-factor authentication, backing up your data regularly, and setting strong, complex passwords. Question number five, what's the difference between malware and ransomware? These are two of the most common terms that appear whenever another cyber attack has hit the news. But what's the difference? Well, malware is the catch-all term for software that was created to disrupt and/or gain unauthorized access to a computer. One of the most common examples of malware is spyware, software implanted on a device specifically to gather data under the victim's nose. Ransomware is another incredibly common form of malware. The clue of what it does is in the name. Once a hacker has infected your computer with ransomware, they can encrypt your files and demand payment from the victim to get access to them again. The criminal is literally holding your computer for ransom. And there we have it. There are plenty more cybersecurity questions we missed, so keep your eyes on the official NordVPN YouTube channel for a part two. Make sure you don't miss it by subscribing to the channel and pressing the bell icon so you will be notified of each new video. Did you know that one of the best ways to secure your iPhone is to disable your lock screen functions? Find out more with some of our other videos here.